So let's take up numericals now. We'll take up the numericals from your textbook. A pipe 30 centimeter long, let's go. See, if you have to consider the edge effect, diameter will be given, okay? And then only you should consider edge effect. If diameter of the pipe is not given, ignore edge effects. In your school level exams, edge effect will not be there. In JEE kind of numericals, edge effect will be there once in a while. Okay, they will be mentioning it, that ignore edge effect or consider edge effect, something like that. So the length of the pipe is 30 centimeter. It is open at both ends. You need to find out which harmonic mode the pipe resonates with. 1.1 kilohertz source. The velocity of sound is given as 330 meter per second. Which harmonic mode? Will even harmonic exist here?
Yes.
Yeah,
yeah.
It will.
It's open, sorry.
Second harmonic thing.
All of you getting second harmonic?
Yes,
sir. N is equal to 1. Are there?
No, N is equal to 2.
N is 2. It's
2L.
What is the formula for the frequency?
N by 2L
times velocity. Velocity is root b by rho. Okay? This should be equal to what? 1100. Okay? So n will come out to be equal to 1100 into 2 into L, tangya L 30 centimeter divided by V 330. This comes out to be 2. So second harmonic. Kita simple hai. Right? Any doubt? Now one end is closed. Find out which harmonic now. If you close one of the ends, then which harmonic?
N is 2.5.
It won't exist.
It won't exist. Will the wave know that their one end is closed now? The wave was there, you suddenly closed one of the ends. Okay, so basically, this is what was happening. N equal to 2, right? So second harmonic, this is what was happening. This what was happening? Yes or no? Are you somewhere? Now you're closing this end. This end is closed. How can the closed end be the antinode? It is not possible. You need to tell me if the cross section area is kitna le? Cross section area le lo 100 centimeter square. You need to find out how much water should you pour on this. How much water you should pour on this so that it starts resonating. Ignore edge effects. Pouring water means what? If I pour water, exactly what is happening? The length is decreasing. How much water I have to pour? I have to pour water at least up till here. This much water I should pour, then only the close end will be node, and now 1.1. The frequency is unchanged. Just one part of the wave is removed and it is resonating now. Are you getting this? Yes, sir.
So
750 centimeters.
How much is this distance? Height of the water column is how much? Lambda by 4? Lambda by 4? So the volume of the water is lambda by 4 into 100 centimeter square. This much meter cube. Okay. So the mass of the water is density, which is 1000 into 100 into 10 to the power minus 4 into wavelength divided by 4. Okay. This came sometime in JEE. Okay. Sometime back.
Mains or advanced?
That time, advanced, there was no concept of advanced. Okay, what we'll do is that we'll finish the chapter first, and then one full class will do only problems of this chapter. Okay? By the way, any doubts? Yes, what is the doubt? I will have any doubts, Guri was like, yes. Okay, no doubts.
Sir, in this question, are we considering the wave traveling in water?
Wave traveling inside water, you're saying?
It will go.
It will go, it will get transmitted. But we are ignoring that.
How do we know when they ignore that?
It will be mentioned, right?
That's what you did in school, right? That experiment. That's how you use water.
I looked at my entire that experiment.
Yeah, which experiment? Same experiment. Oh, you pour water and see where the sound of the where the sound is maximum. So when sound is maximum, it starts resonating actually. Same thing. Okay, so let's finish the chapter first. Take off beats. Have you heard of beats? What is beats?
It's those that you get when you pull up the guitar and you know.
So, तुम लोग को beats लग रहा है ये जो songs वगैरह में beats रहता है वो क्या? No, it's not that. देखो beats. I can make you hear beats. Let me find out if I can get it. Okay, hear this out. This single frequency, only one frequency is there right now. Now I am changing frequency of one of the wave. They are superposing. Listen carefully. Okay, or it'll increase more. You can try it. Ding 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 like that it does like. Now I'll open up another video. On YouTube, if I search beats, beat physics, so matlab. this one. Watch this at home. Write down, beats is an interesting phenomena arising from interference of waves. Let's go. So basically this is also superposition, but the two waves that are meeting, they don't have same frequencies. the frequencies are different. Okay, so first time we are superposing two waves having different frequencies, and let's see what is happening here. So in your textbook they have taken cosine wave for some reason, so let's take cosine only. First sound wave is longitudinal, so we'll take S1 is equal to, don't talk, A cos kx minus omega 1t. Frequencies are different, everything else is same. A cos kx minus omega 2t. Here are the two sound waves that are meeting each other, they are superposing. Okay, now the trick is I am putting my coordinate axis in such a manner that wherever I am superposing, I am taking that as origin. So the value of x will become 0, right? So I am assuming that I am standing at the origin and I am hearing these two sounds, A cos omega 1t and A cos omega 2t. So add these two and see what you will get. Done? It will be 2a cos of omega 1 This is what you'll get. Any doubt? What is omega, by the way? Angular frequency. Omega is angular frequency. And this is what you'll get. The interesting thing here is that you get two time terms. Till now you are getting one time term and one x term. Now you have two time terms multiplied with each other. So visualizing this becomes tricky. Okay. So we'll take case for the beats. We'll take a case if omega 1 and omega 2 are high frequencies but close to each other. Okay, but they are not so close that omega 1 minus omega 2 becomes 0. No. Okay, one could be like, for example, 300, other could be 294, something like this. Okay, with time, now tell me what will happen. This will change with time, this bracket term, with time. This will also change with time. Who is changing faster? The frequency of second one is higher?
Yeah.
Very high. Frequency of the first term is? Very low. Are you getting it? So, we humans can't hear a frequency which is very high. So, we will not be able to hear this fluctuation. But we will be able to hear that fluctuation. So if omega 1 and omega 2 are close to each other, we are going to hear this fluctuation only. Our ears will automatically filter out that. Okay, so let's see how the graph will look like for this. So let's say I'm drawing on this. This fluctuation will rapidly fluctuate. Okay, so it will fluctuate something like this. So this is the kind of fluctuation you will see, and on top of it, there are two frequencies. One frequency is frequency of fluctuation, the other frequency is the frequency with which the amplitude is changing. Are you getting it? Okay, so we are going to hear this fluctuation. That fluctuation our ears can hear, but this rapid fluctuation our ears can't hear. Okay? Fine? So this is the phenomenon of beat. When two frequencies which are close to each other, please write it down, when two frequencies close to each other superpose, two frequency close to each other superpose, beats will get generated. The beats will get generated. Now let's talk about beat frequency. With what frequency I hear the sound? Will whatever I am hearing, the frequency of that will be equal to the frequency of the wave or not? What I hear the wave or the intensity of the wave? Intensity of the wave, right? Intensity depends on amplitude square. Whether it goes to plus A or minus A, the effect of to my ears will be same. Okay, so in one time period, starting from here to here, there will be two ups and two downs. Are you getting it? Okay, so basically, if you just focus on one wave part of it, let's say this is what I'm focusing on. So there will be one portion and two portion, two things will be there which will have the same effect. Okay, so what I'm hearing is two times of that frequency. Getting it? So the frequency with which I am hearing is omega 1 minus omega 2. This is called the beat angular frequency. This angular frequency, so beat frequency will be what? Frequency of beat will be equal to F1 minus F2. Okay? पहले लिख लो फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ बीट विल बी एफ वन माइनस एफ टू ओके नाउ टेल मी कैन एफ टू बी मोर देन एफ वन देन बीट फ्रीक्वेंसी विल बी नेगेटिव इट विल बी मॉड ऑफ दैट इजंट इट सो बेसिकली 300 गाइस लिसन हियर 300 एंड 296 विल आल्सो गिव यू फोर बीट्स 300 and 304 will also give you 4 beats. So it could be 4 less or 4 more also for the beat frequency. Getting it? Okay, any doubts?
Yes, sir. So why is your beat wave a standing wave?
It's not a standing wave actually. I should not have drawn this portion. It's like this. It looks like standing wave for the orange one, but that is not a standing wave. It's a rapid fluctuation.
Yes. Sir.
It is not a standing wave.
So that one entire thing is one beat, like yellow part.
This is one wave. In this one wave, you will hear two loud sounds. You will hear loud sound corresponding to this situation and corresponding to that situation.
So you hear two loud sounds per wave.
Per wave. Per one wavelength, you hear two loud sounds. So the frequency of beat is two times the frequency of that thing. So that is that two times of that is the beat frequency.
So this frequency of beat is not the like
frequency of wave.
Frequency. It's
no.
Just how many times you hear the difference.
Entire beat phenomena is what we hear. In reality, this is also happening, but we are ignoring this. Why? Because we are not able to hear it. So beat is with respect to what humans can hear.
So in this case, both the beats will sound the same way.
Yeah.
On the crest amplitude.
Intensity is amplitude square. Any other doubt? No doubts.